And switching gears now, our next guest on the show is taking part in a musical that brings the work of the late playwright Jonathan Larson to Manila. Tick, Tick, Boom follows Larson's struggles as an up-and-coming composer, and the Philippines' adaptation of it will have its final show this Sunday. So why is it a must-see? Let's ask the stars of the play themselves, Kayla Rivera and Jeff Flores. Jeff and Kayla, welcome to the program.
Hi, how are you?
All right, so let's get to it. Why should we watch the final run of this play?
Well, our show has been really well received, and we're so happy to welcome all of these new audiences to the theater. It's fun. And not only that, it's really good for, it's like very touching for the creative in everyone.
Kayla, this particular play actually talks about the struggles of an up-and-coming playwright. Can you actually identify with John Larson and his struggles while you were going through the play? And I understand this is your first time on this play.
Yeah, I definitely can relate to him. I mean, when I had finished university, I decided to pursue performing instead of going straight to university. And, you know, a lot of my friends took that route of going into university and you know, getting a regular corporate job, I guess. And so for me, it was kind of like, I always battled, like, should I still pursue my passion? Or should I also take that route and, you know, get that stable job? So, you know, I definitely can relate to Jonathan Larson and, you know, all the struggles he went through. But ultimately, in the end, you know, going for your passion and what you love most, it will always be worth it. It'll be a struggle, but it will always be worth it.
Jeff, talk to us about, is there a particular scene there in the play that resonated with you? That struck a chord with respect to your experience? I understand this is your second time being involved in the play. How was it coming along the second time around?
It's more developed this time around. Like, as I mature as a person, like, I feel like the role matures with me. All of the lines, the story of Jonathan Larson is all about pursuing your passion. And pursuing your passion as a person who is fighting the clock and getting a little older and feeling like they're running out of time. And time is kind of like a concept that's become very important to everyone lately, especially coming out of our extended 3-year vacation that we've all had. And so people are coming to the theater and it's resonating with them in this very, very interesting way. I feel like that I'm running out of time as a freelance artist, as a person who's always like bouncing in between projects and between gigs. And so I'm always afraid that it's going to run out. And so that's really been a centerpiece of my performance this time around.
And there's talk about the so-called milestone anxiety of you not being able to achieve a certain goal within a certain period of time. Kayla, have you had that feeling in your pursuit of this career that, wait, I'm not where I'm supposed to be? And look, I'm what, 30, 35, 40? I don't know how old you are, but could you relate to that experience?
Yeah, I definitely can. And I think, you know, with nowadays everything beyond social media, with us always comparing to one another, that also heightens it even more. So I think it's a challenge that all of us will deal with no matter what, even if we're in our 20s, whether we're in our 50s, whatever the age is, it's always going to be something that we all, you know, feel the pressure of time. And, you know, as Jeff was saying, you know, we had the 3 years of that extended vacation, but that just really made us not take time for granted and realize how precious time is and how we should just make the most of it.
Jeff, how different is this play from other plays that you've been involved in? What made it stand out for you?
The flow in general is very, very unique. In Tick, Tick, Boom, it's a full musical with all these production numbers and all these songs and all these scenes, but with a cast of only 3 people. So the role of John, which I alternate with Khalil Ramos in, is mostly narration and singing, whereas Kayla and her respective Michael, there are 2 other actors who play every other role. And so they switch costumes, they do quick changes, they're switching wigs, they're switching accents. And it's a very, very rapid fire, and it's very, very entertaining.
So.
Of course, there's actually a movie adaptation of this play on Netflix. Some might have watched it. But why do you think watching it on a theater live makes it a better experience for everyone? Kayla.
Well, like Jeff was saying, with myself playing the role of Susan and then Tanya Manalang, we alternate on the role, and then there's also Mike, that's played by Reb Atedero and Dan King. We basically take on all the characters that you would see in the movie, so we bring that to life to the theater stage. But I think at the same time, I think it really just hits home, especially with everyone coming back into the flow of things, into pursuing their passion again. And when they're reminded of this message that we have to share, that time is so precious, pursuing your passion, I think they can just relate to actually not just Jonathan, but even Susan and even Mike. So I feel like when you watch this on the theater stage and you feel it live, you're in that energy that we're all sharing in the theater. You can't help but feel seen. You can't help but feel understood. And it makes you feel less alone because, you're like, you know what? I'm not the only one going through this. This is happening right in front of me. And, these are ways that I can navigate through these challenges in life.
And Jeff, there's been a resurgence, so to speak, of the entertainment industry after the pandemic. You have movies coming out, and then you have also plays like Hamilton is coming to Manila. How do you feel about these developments?
We're super excited. I'm super excited because when we did the Tick Tick Boom in 2016, mind you, it was before the Netflix movie, the audiences weren't as such. Sometimes, you have to campaign hard to get people into the theater, but now they're coming in droves and they're super excited. Attendance has been incredible, reception has been incredible, and I think people are really excited to connect again, especially in live theater, where you can look into an audience's face and you can see the performer sweating in front of you, and there's this palpable theatrical energy, especially because the show of Tick Tick Boom is about theater. It's about how something is very special about theater. And I think that the audience really feels that this time around.
It also provides an insight on the struggles that you creative artists go through. For you, Kayla, are you expecting more plays to come in the coming months? Do you have some things lined up after Tick Tick Boom?
Definitely just looking forward to what's to come. I think right now, we're just so excited that there's so many musicals, there's so many plays that are happening. So for me, I just look forward to whatever is to come. As of right now, I don't have anything lined up after this, but fingers crossed for reruns. I mean, I feel like this isn't the end for Tick Tick Boom. We're all just clinging on for dear life. Like, please, for a rerun, whether it's here in the Philippines or elsewhere, I don't know, who knows, but just really excited for everything that's happening. And, Reb will always end our show saying, Philippine theater is alive. So I think we can all just take pride in that and just be really excited for what's to come.
And Jeff, what's next for you after this play?
I'm in the same boat as Kayla. I don't have another project. I'm due for a break. I could th this is a tough show, and I could use a little break, but it's so bittersweet that it has to end this weekend. And so I'm just holding on for dear life and holding on, making sure that we can finish this one really strong.
How long did you prepare for this?
About 70 to 75 days, 6 weeks, about a month and a half.
Right. Now, is there a particular, I'm curious, is there a particular play that you'd like to be adopted here in the Philippines and you'd like to star in? Could be a Broadway musical or West End.
Ooh, I've got nothing, Kayla. Do you have a dream show?
Well, I feel like Hamilton. I would love to play Eliza, but I think that me watching it this September is going to be already like really fulfilling. But if that's one role that I would love to do one day, it would be that one. Yeah.
Right. No dream role, Jeff, really? Like, you must
Well,
have dreamt of playing somebody.
I was gonna say Hamilton, but I feel like that's
Oh, let's do it. Just kidding.
Yeah, but what are you, they're coming now. What are we gonna do now?
First, watch it and perhaps audition for the next run.
Yeah, perhaps. Yeah, maybe we'll go watch it, and then they'll need a swing or something.
Yeah. We'll prepare.
All right, all right. So we're excited for you. What can we expect on the last run this weekend? Can you invite them? Where can we buy tickets? What's the schedule for the last few showings?
Oh yeah, this weekend is going to be great. We have three and only three shows starting on September 2. We have a matinee at 3 p.m. Then we have an evening show on September 2 at 7:30. And then we have our closing show where you can catch me and Kayla on September 3. That's 3 p.m. matinee at RCBC Plaza here in Makati.
That's
All
right.
right,
Yeah.
last words to you, Kayla.
To get tickets, you can get them on tickettome.net. And just also make sure to follow us on our socials. That's 9WT online. And also, if you're going to be watching or posting, please use the hashtag tick tick boom MNL. But we just want to say thank you to all of our audiences as well because of you guys supporting us. I know some people have watched twice or three times to see the
Wow.
different pass. We just want to say thank you very much because it's because of you that we've extended and we have the chance to do the shows this weekend. So thank you, and we look forward to seeing everyone at the theater this weekend.
All right, and Dana, thank you so much for joining us this morning, Kayla Rivera and Jeff Larson. Good luck in your final shows.
Thank you, Mike. Thank you.